So hi you all, welcome and thanks for joining with us. We got lots of response regarding AWS and your C and Java. We'll touch all those session in upcoming webinar, and today is the second session for Git. So I'm transferring this session to Sandeep, and after Sandeep, I think Ramesh can start the today's session.
So hi students, like the first session was on Git UI, so and also like the video was shared to you all. So if anybody have some question regarding the first session or any difficulty or any stoppage, they can ask Ramesh can start, right?
Yep.
Yeah, okay.
Hey, hi everyone, I'm Ramesh and I have a year of experience in DevOps engineering with the cloud and all the networking sections. So today I am going to tell you how to do all the Git things which earlier told by the Sandeep in a browse sections and UI version. And today I will go with the CLI version, how we do with the terminal or command line prompt CMD. So let's start the sessions. And if you have any doubt and anything, you can ask the questions in between that. So right now I'm sharing my screen. So I give you some commands which I generally used in these sessions, like what all the commands like that. That some is a CD command. CD command is used for change the directory. Suppose I type pwd, it give me the directory name in which I am recently in, like that user Ramesh, I am in user Ramesh. So if I want to go some other directory, so I need to CD and then the directory name like desktop. So I will change into that directory. And then another command is like ls command. Ls command is list ls whatever the file or folder present in the directory, that will display here. And another command is touch command. Touch command is used for creating file or anything. Let's suppose I create a file for like git demo.sh, then it will create a blank file for me. If you want to see, then I can see ls hyphen pipe git demo sh, it will here. If I want to, so I can, there is nothing inside that file. So basically I use this 3 to 4 command in the sessions. If you have any doubt in this command, you can ask or I can go further. Okay, fine. So let's start with the Git. So first I go to the Git repo. And this is our Git repo, which this is created by the Tech Diksha teams for demo purpose. So I go to that repo and just I click on clone and downloads. Clone and downloads is like a copy of file or folder. So in Git that name is clone, not different. Like if you copy some, if you want to copy a file, then you use copy command, so that whatever the context is in that file or folder, it will come to your new file and folder. So same things happen here. So I go to that and git clone, I will clone here. And then I go to my command line. Git, the option is git clone, and whatever I have copied, I pasted it here. And I am doing, so it is cloning the repo. See, it's cloning into etake diksha demo. And it's cloned, it's 100% done. So I need to go into that directory, means on that directory or that repo or that folder. The all are the same, but the different name is there. So don't confuse with the name that you call folder, you call repo, you call whatever the terms is all the same. So I go to that repo and here I am in the git master. So first I check my branch key, in which branch I am. So I need to write git branch, branch. Git branch will give me the branch name in which I am. So I am in a master. And if you want to see all the branches in that git repo, so you need to do git branch minus a. it will give all the branches which is created on that repo. So it will give me all the branches, see, like master, head, ABCD, and res. And so this is, and another thing is that if you want to check the Git, means remote version, means which Git remote version are you origin, or you want to add some other own remote version, and then you want to write your code and everything, and then you push into the origin or the master branch. So you can check it with remote. So I am in origin branch. So I have a two axis, fetch and push. I can fetch it also and push it also. Whatever I want, I can do it from here itself. So another command is, I need to check the Git status key, whatever the status of that master branch. Either I need to take push or pull. How you know that, let's suppose you are working in a company and lots of developers and are working on that section. So that they are pushing their code into that master repo. So how you know that something's happened in that repo or not like that? So we will do Git status. So in this, it will show on branch master, your branch is up to date with origin master, means my branch is up to date. So no need to do anything. Again, then we will create a new branch. Let's create a new branch, Git. There is a two option to create a branch. Either you can go with Git branch name, let's suppose for that. So I create a branch. So there is two way of creating a branch. One is Git branch and branch name. Let's suppose I give the branch name and Git demo. So it's created. So my branch is created. If you check, then if you want to go into that branch, because right now in the master, and then I want to go to the Git demo branch. So I need to do Git checkout. Checkout is for going into that branch. So I do that Git checkout branch. So switch it into Git demo. So it is displaying here ki Git demo is there. If you want to check especially, so Git branch. If you do Git branch, then it will show Git demo C. And the another way is that you can create with the checkout directly. So if you do git checkout -b is for branch, and then you directly check out that this command, what it will do, it will first create the branch and then move to the branch. So if I create a branch like git check demo, so switch to new branch git check demo C. So the thing is that we use this command, so we can avoid one steps of that, because if you go with the git branch and branch name, then you have created a branch and then you have to check out and then you have to go to that branch. So and another simplest way is that git checkout -b git demo. So it will first create the branch and then it will be check out to that branch. So I am in the git checkout git branch. So I check the git status. So nothing is there. And if I want to change the branch, so same thing, git checkout master. I am in the master branch. Okay, if you want to check the status, I mean log key, whoever push the code or what is going on in this master, so you use git logs. So in this, you can see all the things like key, merge code number this Ramesh on Saturday, I push some coded here. On Saturday, I have done something. On Monday, I have done something. On Sunday, that is taken by the Sandeep. He is doing something on that repo. So whatever happening in this repo, it will show here. Whatever, and there is a lots of flags are there, so that you can specify with the means date also, or means with committer name also, like that. So the code. So I will check out with that git branch. So I will go into the branch which I have created. So I will check out that branch. So command for that, git checkout and branch name. I will on that branch. Okay, and then I will check git status key. Is there things happen? So nothing to comment. Working tree are clean. Everything is working fine. So if let's suppose I created a file and I want to push that file to our main repo. In that scenario, I will what I can do ki I will print echo hello world. And then command like let's suppose I create git demo. So my branch get if I do ls c git demo sh and if you check with this, so hello world is there. So and everything is fine. Then I check git status. So it will show that one file is added. See, git demo sh. There is a one file which I have already created. So they are asking that you want to push or anything like that. So if you want to push, then you need to do git add. So if you we can add the file in two ways. One is I like git demo sh is git add. It will add my file, or another way is that git add dot. What is the difference between git add a specific file name or git add dot? So if I do git add demo dot sh, it will only add this file to that repo, that branch. If I do git add dot, it means ki whatever present in this repository, means in this branch, it will add all the things to that branch. So I do git add, and then I need to do git commit. So after git commit minus m and message, whatever the message you want to display, but the message should be a valid so that people can understand ki what exactly you are doing with this branch. No random message, nothing like that. But so I give here push file for demo purpose. Push file for demo, and then I enter. So it told me ki your one file is changed, one file is mentioned, and that git demo dot sh. This file is added to this one. So I have done all the things, and then I need to push our repository means branch to the git master. So what I can do, git push origin because I am in origin remote, and then git check demo because this is my branch which I want to push into that git. So see, so everything in counter 4 object is done. Counting object 100%, 4 out of 4, everything is done. There is nothing is to that, everything is done. And it say that remote create a pull request for git check demo on GitHub to visit. So it give me a URL so that I can take the pull request because I push the code. They what is I mean push and pull? Push means you have given something to the git, and pull means you want something from the git. So whatever, for that purpose we use git push or git pull. Git push means you want something from git, whatever the present in git. You push means you want something given to the git, means you want to give something to git. But in pull, whatever you want, you want to take something from git. So giving or taking, giving is push or taking is pull. The best example is giving is push and taking is pull. So it give me the URL key. You go there and you can take the pull. So I directly click on that and it will go to the here. So it's come here, and when I refresh this page, and go to the repository, it a picture demo, and see there is a branch coming. See one branch ago by Ramesh Kumar. Active branch git check demo updated 2 minutes ago. Here it is showing. So if you want to take, here it is saying that ki you want to pull this request or delete it. So I want to pull it. So I click on new pull request. So new pull request, here it's okay. Whatever the message you want, push a file for demo, which is the committing, which I have given the message in a commit git commit message, and whatever the message, like anything like the for demo purpose, whatever the logical things you need to put here so that your team worker can understand exactly what you want to do with this file or this branch, so that he can understand for demo. So I create a pull request and it's created, it's checking. So this branch has no conflict with the base branch. Base branch, which is our base branch? The base branch is the master branch. Always the base branch is the master branch. The comparison happened between the master and your branch. So if everything is working fine, then it's okay. If it is not working fine with the base branch, then it's give a conflict. Means some issues in there in the file, that's why it's giving a conflict. So again, I have to merge the pull request, because this whatever the file I have pushed into this repository, means that branch, git check demo, I need to push that code to the, push to that file to the our main branch, means our master branch, because everyone is using master branch, not your branch. So I will do merge pull request. So it's merge, and when you go to that, you take the char repo. See, our file comes here, git demo.sh, and if you open that file, it's so hello world. So like that we are doing. Okay, and one thing is that, so, and another question is that because I am contributor here, so I can push and pull directly whatever I want. But what's happened when you are not a, see, Ramesh Kumar Jha is a contributor here, and is repo is a contributor here. So these both two guys can do whatever he want to do, he can do here. But what happened when you are not a contributor or you don't have a access to do anything, right? So in that case, what you will do? Let's take an example. So I am not author, or I have a confidential credentials for this. So if I directly clone the branch and then I go come out from here, and then I git clone this branch, cgd exercise, it is cloning. So again, when I create a new branch and push something, then it's give a error that you don't have a access or like that. So once it's cloned, I will show you how it will happen. So cgd exercise, I mean master branch. So if you check git status, so up to branch, so I create a new branch here. I created a new branch here and I am that branch. And let's suppose I create a new file. So I have created a new branch. If you check ls, so abcd.sh here. So if I want to push that branch, if I check git status, so abcd.sh is that file. And when I add this file, git add dot, I add this file and then I commit, same process I have followed, which I have showed you before, that git commit minus m. I commit this message, one SSN, and when I post this thing, so it will give me error, git demo dot git demo git post origin demo. So see, it will give errors to me. It is validating I am dead or the partner. So see, permission for this is precisely denied to Ramesh Kumar because I don't have any permissions to directly push this anything to this branch. So that's why I am not able to push directly. So what I have to do, first I need to do fork from here, fork the branch. So once I fork it, forking Ramesh Kumar. So once I forked it, I fork. Fork or clone are both are the same, but what happened with fork and clone that you can only push and pull in a clone only when you are the contributor. But if you want to contribute anything in a public repository, first you have to fork and then you have to clone the repo. So you can not directly push or pull anything into the fork branch. So like that, and then so I have to come out from here and I need to remove that directly rm minus rm this one. I remove that directory and then I have to git clone that directory. So I the already it's cloned and then I go to this directory in cd exercise which I have cloned the repo. I am in master. If I check git status, everything is up to branch. Git log, so whoever the committer will show here and what they are committed, when they are committed, how they are committed, and there are lots of flag for this. If you want to check by date, then you can use that. There are hell number of flags which we can use for that for a particular reason. Only when we want to show only for last 1 month, then I can use the date method and then like that. So what I can do, I create a new branch, git checkout -b and branch name remote restart.yaml. I created a branch restart. I'm in the branch. If you check git branch, so I am in the restart branch. Then I create a file, YAML file, vi.yaml, restart.yaml. And then I can write some branch like this repo is for Kubernetes. So I write the restart, how to restart the container or anything like. So for that, there is a command kubectl rollout restart and deployment name. So this is the command deployment name. So I create, this is the command which is used to restart the container or things pod in the Kubernetes world. So I save that file and then if you see ls grep and restart.yaml. So restart.yaml is there. So I need then same process is git add, it will add the file, and git commit -m commit message, whatever I want to print command for restart the pod in kube world. So this is a command for kubeworld. So I commit this. The most similar command is commit. Okay. Yeah, I misspelled the meaning. Sorry for that. So I made it that, and then again I have to do the same process because I will not push this branch because this is the public repo and I cannot push anything like this because of the reasons they may blacklisted my user ID for that repo. So but the same command we need to follow, git push origin, and then it will push to the master branch and then restart like that, and then same things happen. You need to do that things. Again, error permission denied. Same things happen due to the reason because I don't have the permissions. So once he gave the permission, then I am able to do the push and pull the things, all the things. Right now, the question sessions for your sites, any question or anything you can ask. Hello.
Yeah, hi Ramesh, I'm audible to you.
Yes.
So we are having one question from Jai Thakur that please tell git difference and git commit.
Git difference and git commit is like git difference will show you exactly
so
what is
the question is git difference and git status.
Git difference and git status. Git difference or git status is like that ki both are the same, but the main difference between that ki git status will show what is the status of your file or folder or like that. But if you do git difference, it will show the difference between your file before before committing, however the file is looking, and after committing, after changing, how is your file looking. The main difference between git status or git difference is that.
Okay, so I hope the answer is clear to Jai Thakur. Another question is from Kuntal. I think he started in the beginning that sir, what is the difference between fetching origin and pulling origin?
Fetching origin or pulling origin, just I have explained earlier ki fetch what is the question, fetch origin or pull origin? Like fetch origin means ki it will give you all the means recent changes or recent things in that git on master branch or any branch. But git pull will be specific to your branch. Like let's suppose your developer created a branch and you are a means I'm just giving example, your developer is created a branch, and then how you can check that ki whatever the branch name is that there or not, how you can check out to that branch. Let's suppose a developer give you the branch name application for a branch. So how you know that ki this is the branch? This is the branch. How you can take that branch? So you need to do first git fetch. So if you do git fetch na, then it will come all the branches related to that repository git, and then after that you take the branch and then git checkout that branch name. After going to the checkout to that branch, you need to pull that code to your local repository. So you do git pull origin and branch name, then it will pull your code. Understand what exactly I tell? The main difference between fetch and pull is fetch is related to your branch. Let's suppose I take the another example itself also. If your developer or if your any team member create a branch and write some code and tell you that ki I am creating this branch. So how you know that ki this where is this branch, and how you know that ki is this branch existing or not? So you do git fetch. Once you do the git fetch, it will tell you all the branches related to that. And then after you take the branch from there, it's so you can push or it is from origin branch or it is from the remote some other remote version or remote version from origin like that. So once you take that branch name, then you do git checkout branch name. Once you check out to that branch, then you need to pull the code which is present in the branch into your local repository so that you can do whatever you want to do, because you don't change anything in that branch. So you just check up, pull that branch, and whatever you want to do, you can do it here itself. And if you again, then again, if you do the git status, then it's okay. You have done some changes in this file, but it don't tell you ki what exactly changes. So in that case, we do git difference, git and space diff. Git diff exactly told you ki whatever the previous code is there and what you have changed in recently. So is it clear exactly? I give you the proper explanation for that, how to fetch to diff.
So Kuntal replied, he got the answer, and we got the question from Pritima. Sir, whenever I did a commit from a web GUI, the commit is showing as verified, but if I make a commit from CLI, the verified mark is not in the commit. I want to know why this is happening.
Okay, let me sir, whenever I did a commit from the web GUI, the commit is showing as verified, but if I make commit from CLI, the verified mark is not in the commit. I want to know why this is happening. See, because in GUI each and everything is visual, but in CLI whatever what is happening, ki if you do something, it will do internally everything. If you get false, means it will reflect the answer when you are doing some mistakes. If you are doing means if you are doing in a right way or in a proper way, then it will not say anything. It will, because you are doing in a proper way, then there is a no means of, means in CLI terms, there is a no means of saying you are doing the good thing. You are doing the good thing, that's why they are taking you. So, and if you are doing some mistake, it will reflect there ki you are doing some mistakes here or like that. Like I can show you an example of that. Let's suppose I am that this CKD exercise, or let's suppose anything. There are, I don't know that. So let's suppose same process I am following. I am creating a branch. I am on that branch and I add a file. So I write a Python script and I want to run this. Is it everything is fine? Yeah, it is everything fine. And when I am adding this file git add, let's suppose git add, and I don't give the file name also, and I'm not giving the dot options also. So see, it will tell here. See, nothing specified, nothing added. Maybe you wanted to say git add dot. So it give a recommendations. So because I have done a mistake here. So if there is a, if you are doing some mistakes, then it automatically gives you the answer. If you are not doing the doing anything wrong, then it will not give anything. So it just push the code or whatever you want to do. Understand? Or I have to explain it in another way or like that. In another term.
Okay. Pritima replied okay from his side. So guys, anyone have any other question?
Hello Ramesh, this is Pawan. Am I audible?
Pawan, you are audible.
Actually I have not started this, I mean joined this session from the beginning, but I might have some thing missed from the starting session, but I have used the Tortoise to it. And there some GUI based options are there. So what is the basic difference between this command prompt and our Tortoise JIT GUI based option? Means is it for admin or that is for end user?
No, it is not like that, end user or GUI or like that. But why exactly the CLI version recommended is that ki whenever you are working with a lots of tasks and there is a lots of things are there. So if you are doing with the GUI, so first you need to click that things and then select all the things and then you have to do that all the thing. But in Git CLI, just you do, type a command and then whatever is that you can paste it there and just click it into it will go automatically. It makes a work easier. So basically, no difference between the Git CLI and Git UI because GUI. There is not like that. So you can use anything, but for administrative purpose, like I am a DevOps, so I most preferably go with the CLI version in any things like Kubernetes or any world, any tools which I am using, Jenkins or whatever patterns, everything. I can write a pattern in the CodeChamp also or any way. But I prefer here because if I have to work in a multiple tasks, I can do it randomly. Go this side and do this side and then this side. If I want to do three times, so I open the tab and I am doing these things. So no need to open a lots of tab and I'm moving this and this side. So it's better to do with the CLI. As for my knowledge, means what I exactly know and why we are using the CLI version.
Okay, thank you. Actually, I was using the Tortoise just to maintain the code and no further uses. Means till that time, I used that one. So only the push, pull and some difference and commit was there and it was UI based.
Let's suppose there is a lots of command, like so let's suppose you want to check what major facility giving the using with the CLI version. Let's suppose you want to check a commit from the specific person, then how you check with the GUI version? Is it not like that? But in your CLI version, you can check it. So
okay. Thank you.
Okay, welcome.
Ramesh, we are having one more question from Jay Thakur, which is how can I fix broken commit?
So if you are using any like Intel Azure or anything, so or Git, if when you do the Git diff or anything, then it will show the conflict where exactly you are doing the wrong things. That's why you are not able to commit to your code. So you have to go to that sections and then you have to do that things. Okay, let's suppose you have some syntax error or some variable missing. Let's suppose you define a variable A is equal to ABCD but you are using you are declaring same variable in another using the same variable but putting the another value. So it will not take because you have already declared a variable with that value. So you are getting that conflict. So you need when you are doing that things and if you have a conflict in between that, then at that in the it will show that there is a difference between this and this, which I have earlier mentioned. This is the previous one and this is the this one. That's why you are not able to complete. So you need to go to the debugger codes where exactly I am doing the mistakes, and then you have to step up out and you have to fix it out your code on that sections, and then you will able to commit that code. So it's depend upon the scenario or like that. So it's not like that key something. Let's suppose you have a configurations file or env file, and let's suppose your code is means your environment is using no production environment, but you are giving the stage environment. And when you are doing the push means commit the code, and when you are pushing the code, so it will give errors because there is a no production environment or you're giving the staging environment. So how it will work? So it tell you okay, you the difference between this. So you need to change that thing. So again, the question is that okay, how I know that production I have to put here production or not. So again, you have to debug your code. If you are new at the company or you are new working on that repository or anything, then there is a readme file for that. Everyone maintain the readme file. In readme file, each and everything is mentioned that like that key is the is a readme file. He is mentioning each and everything key, what is exactly there, how it is using, and everything is mentioned here. So it will mention that key, how to use that repository for using the repository, or what exactly you have to know, what pre-built configuration you need, what post-built configuration you need to run this code and like that. So you first, if you are doing any, if you are new in any company or anything, so first you need to read the file, readme file of that repository, what exactly is there, so that you can do it according to that. So each and every step is mentioned in the readme file, and then you have to work on according to that.
And yeah, and one more you can do, if there is any syntax error in the project, that can be solved by doing the build of that project. okay, before doing any push or pull or any commit to any of the branches or submitting the code, you should do a build of that file. So that will give you the syntax error. So most of the error will be solved there. Maybe some variables are declared, maybe some syntax error, or maybe some code has been written wrong and some references are missing. So that when you do a build of the project, most of the software has the build facility. So when you do a build, it will give you the syntax error and the references missing. So that you need to add there, and then you need to again do a build. If every error is resolved and you have a successful build, then you can push that or commit that changes into the like said repository. So that will solve your most of the changes. Yeah.
So any other question from anyone else? Guys, still we are having 5 to 10 minutes. So if you have any question, you can post. So Jay is asking regarding that fixed broken commit, manually do I need to fix it or any other command is there for that one?
That git stash is there. It will, whatever the conflict is there, it will save into your local repository and it will fix it. There is a command git stash, gitstash.
Can you show it so that it will be helpful for Jet to address?
Git stash. This is the command git stash. So no local changes to save because there is no any conflict. That's why it is not able to save it. If there is a conflict or anything, then this command will save your conflict things into the local repository and it will push the code which is only required. But it's better to fix the code in manually because it may be missed some things. We can't get a stat check your file things which you have defined, but it is not going inside your files or each and everything. So it's better to check your files. If you are using some tools for like Eclipse or Intel Azure or CodeJam or Visual Code Studio or Atoms or anyone, then if there is a installation, there is a file means that will automatically resolve that problem, and it will give you like that what is exactly error or like that.
Basically, like for example, if some code is changed in a master branch, for example, there is a page called home.html, and in the master branch, one of the developer or the admin has changed some code, and you are also working on the same page. In home.html, and then when you do a commit, it will say you there is a conflict. So the code can tell you the conflict, but which line to keep, that you need to do manual. That is a manual work because the git will not know that the work done by you or work done by your senior or the other developer, which one is the late, which one is the required one. So you need to see the codes one by one, line by line, and whichever you want to keep, you need to keep that and do a resolve issue and merge again. Okay, so that is a manual process, resolving the line by line merge or conflicts. Like basically, most as Ramesh told, Visual Studio and other tools give this, so they will show you which they will do a conflict, and when you go to the conflict, it will show you that which line and which was done by whom. Like it was done by a master, it was done by another branch. It will show you, and if you want to keep all of them, maybe then there is a merge conflict. So then it will keep your master and also your sub and make another file, like make a new, and it will get a commit. So it will be a merge conflict if you want to do it like auto. So it will keep both the codes. Okay.
Yeah, one more question is there. What is bare repository and significance?
Basically, like the bare repository, because like when you are following a tree, like master branch, sub branch, and these all, so you will get a repository within a tree. It's a tree formation. And when you create outside the tree of that that flow, then it's called a bare repository. And in that repository, you can work remotely also, and also into the GitHub. So it will not be from your master branch, and it will not follow your tree. It's a family tree, or you can think father, child, his child, and this, where we create a flow. But if you want a separate without any tree, like without any tree structure, without any references, then you will create another repository on that same project. It's called a bare repository. You can do a merge and everything from there, but it will not follow your tree structure.
What we'll do in case of conflicts?
If there is any conflicts happen, if you do get a status, then it will show, means if it is green and or any another color, then there is a no conflict. If it is there is a conflict, then we use a command that is called git stash, stash. This stash, git stash, what this command will do, whatever your conflict is there, it will remove from your main branch, and it will save into your local repository, means local branch. It will not post your branch, means conflict things into the git repo directly. So it will be there, like I will show you how I can do. So it gets patched. So how I can show the conflict things. So once, let's suppose I go to the GitLS. So let's suppose I made write something, and I can do the things. Git checkout minus b conflict. Okay, I'm in a conflict branch. I create a branch like v dot YAML and vi.conf.yaml file, and insert, and like app is equal to v1 and client is equal to deployment. Okay, fine. I have misprint the value, means there is some syntax error in that file. So once when I go git status, so this is git conflict com.yaml file. So if I do git add dot, and then if I check git status, no conflict come. I think it will take vi some file like conf.yaml. How can I? Let's do app is equal to v1 and deployment. Data. Let's check. I think it will work. conf.yaml. So git stash. Saved a working directory and index data with on conflict this merge pull request 6 from the thing which have the because I have created a file which has a conflict means annotations error in this file. So it, then I do the git stash. It says that we saved the working directory and index step with conflict on this merge pull request from etech diksha. So it will ABCDs. So it will save into the local repository. It will doesn't affect anything. And then whatever the things which is come to the conflict it will hear. And then I can do the git add. And that command config.yaml. And it will add. If you check git status, no conflict is there, nothing is there. On branch conflict there is a nothing, conflict is there and the committed itself. Again we have to do the same process and git commit message minus m and the same for process which we followed, add yaml file. It's committed, one file changes, seek iterations, pluses, and created mode is then 146 for that config mode. And then same process, git push origin your branch name, it will push to that because it didn't give any error because I have access on that, I have a permissions on that file, so it will there and then I can go here and then it will done. Git stash hard. So in git stash hard, what when we use git stash hard, then git stash will not work. Let's suppose you have a hundreds of file and 50 or 60 file, there are issues and that is the major issues like environmental issues or like that. So git there is a AI which work inside the git. It will analyze all the things and each and everything. What we can change or what we cannot change. So mainly it doesn't change your environment file or config file. It will change only your code file, like simple code file which you have. There is a business logic if you have written. But if you have written something mistake in a like DBMS connection error or like some config or environment file. Let's suppose you have an environment file for in which AWS credential is there. Or you have a MySQL credential is there like that, or some environmental file is there to connect your database or to connect your web server to your database and then database to the other services like other microservices. Then at that case, if something in the environmental file, git stash will not work. So you need to do git stash hard. But for if you want to my view, then you don't do git stash hard in any cases because it may impact your all codes and then we will have to do each and everything line by line because once is the code goes merge because DevOps team not looks into that parts key what you have done, what you have saved, give to that branch, they directly pull it, merge it and they directly create a container of that. That's it. So
it is a private repository, so how to like give the access or how to give a control to any collaborator?
Yeah. So there is a two things. You can either you can go to your repository security or setting. In settings, you go to the settings. Sorry, this is another repository. Comes to our repository. It's better to here. You go to the etech demo. Okay. Not signed. One second, give me 1 second. I am not logged in, that's why it is happening. So we can check from here also branch, how many branches are there, conflict ABCD, conflict ABCD, conflict branch. I didn't merge, that's why it's giving the merge option. New pull request is there. For conflict also new pull request here. So active branch is this. So I need to do that thing. And if you come to Where it is security. So we can set the security policy here itself. Set up the security policy, startup. This is the private key, commit new file, not this one. Wait, this call. Here come a security thing, if you check here now, in get repo, then it's come security. Security, here we can give the security to that manage access. If you go to the manage access things, and if I have access, then V-I-C-K-Y-P-A-T. So here you have invited any collaborator yet. So from here I can invite any collaborators and give the name of that collaborator and select that collaborator. Then the mail goes to that collaborator name, and then it will accept that collaborator, and then they have access, whatever the access you want to give them. So and another way is that key, you can set their SSH key also. Manage access. So add new secrets. So what have, if you want to add the any SSH key or anything, then you can give the name and add the their secret SSH key. So for SSH key, you need to do SSH. So you need to add this one there, and then you can, he or she, anyone can access directly. So you don't need to go that sections and use the manage in collaborator sections and then give the access to that. There is two way, either you can add their secret key here, or you can give the collaborator access from there itself. So there is a two way to add the people in your repo or anything.
Okay.
There is a two way. There is a multiple way, but in generally, these two way are works when the like when you are working on an organization and that organization is fully for a security purpose. So
we have covered all the question and answer. So with this, we are ending the session. If you have any question or anything, you just post in the comment section. We'll address that in upcoming session. So post your queries and post your comments if you have anything to share with us.
Okay, thanks everyone. So all the best and stay home, stay safe. Bye bye.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks to all.
Bye. Bye.